Nickel is a naturally occurring element. It's a metal. It has outstanding physical and chemical properties. And these properties make nickel inevitable in our daily life, notably in stainless steel, in pots and pans, in cutlery, in mobile phones, in computers. We see nickel playing an increasing role in emerging and future technologies, such as, for example, EV batteries or in renewable power generation. Criticality usually assesses on the one side supply risk and on the other side the economic importance that a raw material plays. And that criticality assessment varies from region to region. What these assessments all have in common is that they identify a very high economic importance that nickel plays in emerging and future technologies, such as, for example, clean energy provision or in green mobility. And therefore, we consider nickel to be a strategically important raw material with a high economic importance. When people talk about availability of nickel, they often use the terms resources and reserves. And it is important to understand what they mean. Resources describe potential future ore deposits where still exploration needs to be done. And on the other hand, we have reserves where exploration was already done and where we know that these ore deposits can be mined in an economically viable way. Today, there are 90 million tons of nickel reserves known, as well as 300 million tons of nickel resources. Companies are adding on a continuous basis new ore deposits to both the resource as well as to the reserves. At current production levels of 2.5 million tons per year, we can say that there is enough nickel for current and future generations. There are two main types of nickel ores. On the one side, sulfidic ores, and on the other side, lateritic ores. And they are converted into a wide range of different nickel products. There's a common misconception that only sulfidic ores are suitable for batteries, an increasingly important application of nickel. This is not true. Both ores can and are already converted into the nickel qualities suitable for batteries. Nickel is not consumed as oil or gas, it is used. Nickel can be infinitely recycled, and recycled nickel has the same properties as nickel coming from primary sources. 85% of all nickel that leaves the use phase is recycled. More than 80% of all nickel that historically was mined is still in use, meaning that it is available in future to help satisfy the growing demand. It takes a mining company more than a decade between exploration and the production of its first ton of nickel. For recyclers, also significant investments are required before they can start producing nickel from recycling. What both have in common is that they require a stable regulatory framework, which is providing them with long-term planning security, and this will allow nickel to play its critical role in the future.